how big we are and not because that we are the fourth largest in North America, but we do have fourth largest challenges as well. So it's good aspects on that. The whole concept of getting through this integrate was we were having many, many challenges in around projects being gone down, extended amount of time period. Sometimes it's cost overruns. Nobody knows what the deliverables are after a few years. So we have so many challenges on the project management side. And then we take a step back and look around at what exactly the problems are. And we kind of zeroed down that the requirements was our biggest problems. It's very important how we capture the requirement, understand requirement, analyze requirement, and validate requirement, kind of determine what kind of product or what kind of deliverables you're going to give. So the quality of deliverables was very important. Fourth largest, 600 schools, 65K desktops is pretty big. We have five major departments, and in five major departments, the IT services kind of falls under the business services. We have HR facilities, which does the payroll and the union stuff, the union collective bargaining, collective agreements. We have board services, which looks after the strategies moving forward. As far as IT is concerned, Microsoft ERP, Microsoft Shop. We are heavy users of SharePoint, heavy users of all the Microsoft product suites we have. And very recently, we are moving into TFS as well. Talking about the history, so we have about 16 to 18 BAs. What we have challenges in BAs is they receive emails about, oh, we have this business problem, how do we resolve that? They kind of look into the emails and then ad hoc requests, going back to the business, trying to understand more. Then they come back saying that here are the problems, go back to the PM team, the PM gets assigned and immediately deliver a solution. It's kind of like a, I would say, pocketed solutions, not looking at the entire picture on that, because the other BAs have no clue what this BA has done. Very, very practical challenges which we are having. Sometimes the requirement flew from the general manager by the senior executive that we are having these issues, can we resolve it, and general manager kind of runs through the whole thing, which is quite different than a PM running through the initiative. It is quite different than the VA running through these initiatives. And obviously, the size of the initiative matters as well. We have got small, medium, large, different initiatives in that. Inconsistency in requirement gathering process. As a result of that, some people just go in with an interview question, say that, you know, what kind of issues you are having, it, try to come up with the conceptual solutions. It depends upon how good the VA you are. And when you get the answers for the requirements, questions you are asking, actually it depends upon the quality of questions, to be very frank. You know, what you need to know what to ask to get the required answer. Otherwise, you may get a laundry list of the wish list of the client. And how do we deal with that? Once you get the wish list, we are supposed to deliver that. As a result of that, the client expectations kind of has risen, and we have to meet that client expectation, which is very, very tough for us. Knowledge management, we have got various pieces of data, enormous number of student data. We go back to about, I would say, 18 to 20 years very easily. By law, we are supposed to keep many of the transmitting information for 55 years. So we have got lots of challenges on that area. I'm not sure what kind of technology we can use it last for that long. So when the data has been interrelated, becomes an information, as we all know. Information is everywhere. It could be in the documents. It could be in somebody's head. That information coupled with the processes is really the knowledge which Asif talked about a few minutes ago. And that piece of knowledge, we have seen it being chasing our own tail. So that was a scenario over there. We were looking for an integrated solution. Ramp-up time was very low because we were supposed to deliver as soon as we get here the requirement. Okay, when are you delivering this, right? It's all jumping all the phases which we have to go through. The request usually comes from an academics, and academics are basically the reactionary people, right? You see the teacher in the classroom, so kid has a knee problem or he fell down. Immediately I have to attend to the kid, right? Immediately I have to douse this fire. So they are reactionary, they are like kind of, okay, I got to do right now. So by that virtue, they are expecting the turnaround time to be very fast as well. That poses a big challenge for us. So what we did was, we are looking for a product which can help us in our processes. Now again, like I don't believe that the technology and the tools can solve everything. Those technologies don't work by itself. It's the people who make it work. It's the processes who make it work. So it has to fit in with what our goal, because there is, I'm not trying to boil the ocean over here, but trying to leverage what we have, and at the same time, trying to leverage from the technology front, and marry both.